Now Windass has come short to pick up the ball. Windass slips it through to Albion players, and Sheffield Wednesday can come out the other side. Palmer to Bannon, up towards the edge of the penalty area. And now Marvin Johnson hits it towards goal, takes a deflection and goes over the outstretched arm of Alex Palmer into the far corner of the net. And Wednesday take an early lead inside 8.5 minutes at Hillsborough. And the hosts take an early advantage in the Steel City. Wednesday 1, Albion 0.
Thanks, Jez.
They've already won half as many games this season away from home as they did last year. There's Windass looking to loop the ball over Alex Palmer. The flag stays down. It was one long ball from back to front, and Sheffield Wednesday have a 2-0 lead inside the opening half of the first half here at Hillsborough.
Really well. It's kind of just come at him in different heights, and he hasn't managed yet to get on the scoreline. Will this be his opportunity now?
John Swift standing over it. Plenty of pink shirts waiting for the perfect delivery from Albion's number 10. What can he produce? Lofted towards the edge of the six-yard box, and Bartley hits it over the top of the crossbar, and he's furious with himself.
He should be.
Furious,
yep,
that he didn't at least hit the target there. Great delivery from Swift on this right-hand side. Perfect for Bartley. But unfortunately puts it over the top of Beadle's bar, and it remains 2-0 to Wednesday. Forward, not too many options. Gives it back to Mowat, who was square. Mowat to Diangana, drives into the centre of the pitch, cutting in from that right channel, then plays it forward to Fellows, who's 1v1 here against Lowe. First bit of defending for Lowe. Fellows,
brilliant,
cross comes
brilliant.
In over the head, and it's
there it is.
To the back of the net.
There
Albion
it is.
Have one back.
Who is it?
And it's Josh Madger again. Surprise, surprise. Four away games in a row now that he scored for West Bromwich Albion in the league. First man to do that since Diamante Kamara in 2007. Forget all that, though. It could be a goal that gets Albion back into this contest. Fellows again with that step over, the dink, the delivery. And Josh Madger nods in for goal number 7 in the Sky Bet Championship this season. Game on at Hillsborough.
Well, we've been saying it needs to come, it needs to come. And did it come? It was the classic Albion goal, wasn't it? What a ball in. I mean, the ball in is delightful. And Madger, I mean, he's brave as a lion there. I mean, he comes into that far post, heads the ball. He actually gets injured a little bit, hits the post as he does it. Brilliant, game on.
Darnell Furlong has it in his grasp. You know exactly where this one is going.
We sure do. Come on, Carl
Bartley. All the big boys in the box. Hegem and Bartley in there. So two for Obota. In it goes towards for Obota. Bartley looking to get his head on it. Up into the air it goes.
Target.
Comes out to the edge of the penalty area. Moment into the ground.
Oh, there it is!
And into the back
Alex
of the
Mowat
net.
Again!
Over the head of James Beadle.
There it is!
And Albion from 2 goals down are back on level terms at Hillsborough. Mowat, the substitute, scoring, drilled it into the ground, and the pace on the ball took it up and over the Sheffield Wednesday number one, and the Baggies have got themselves back to 2-2, Andy Johnson.
Well, and we deserved it. The second half display has been different class. OK, the manager's, you know, he's made changes, he's recognised it's not worked, and his substitutions have been incredible. Not back to our greatest best, no, but a lot better. Exceptional players of our squad, he really has. And it just shows how vital he is, because we've been terrible without him.
Here come Wednesday, Bannon into the penalty area. A cross goal! It's
3-2! Oh, no!
Anthony Masaba has found the back of the net. He did the damage against the Baggies in April, and he might just have delivered the decisive strike again here today.